Okay, General Azurin, question lang. Ano yung naging lesson dito? Siyempre, being the former Chief PNP, ano ma-advise mo sa ating bagong Chief PNP?
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, sir. Yes, sir, there are lots of lessons to be learned in these proceedings. First, sir, is everybody should be aware, especially the Philippine National Police, that in the law enforcement function of all the law enforcement agencies, sir, dapat ang lahat po ng ating kapulisan, again, I restate na no PNP personnel should be involved in the use, possession, manufacture, sell or trade of any illegal drugs po, sir, because that is one of our mandate na huliin po at hanapin po ang mga sindikato na gumagawa po ng mga illegal na transaksyon lalo na sa droga. Pangalawa, sir, is there is really a need to keep on assessing, evaluating the different policies and laws if they are still relevant, responsive to the present time. And then, pangatlo, sir, is this also an opportunity, sir, for every PNP na tignan po nila na out of the 228,000 PNP, they should not allow themselves na itolerate po ang mga ganitong mga practices ng ibang mga kasamaan namin because ilan-ilan lamang po yan out of the 228,000 na gumagawa po at sumisira po sa aming institusyon. Dapat ay this is a wake-up call for all the PNP personnel na let us not tolerate everyone, especially if they are have so many misgivings or shortcomings, because it is really the people expects that lahat po ay gagawin po ng mga kapulisan, ay lahat po ay gagawin po nila ang tama at kung ano po ang marapat. So sana po muli babalik po ang ating mga PNP, especially our officers, that they need to exercise their leadership at the different levels of the organization. So ang nakita po natin dito ay mali na po yung umpisa nung report. Kaya tuloy-tuloy po na nagkamali po lahat po ng mga succeeding po na mga activities, na mga programa. So this is this should be a lesson sa lahat po ng ating mga operating unit na let us supervise our people on the ground. Let us not allow that we will be influenced by the few scalawags and misfits in the uniform service. So dito po nakikita po natin how they really manipulated siguro ang director ng PDEG. They made him believe na yung operation nila ay legit. That's why nakikita po natin na medyo nalilito po dito si Police Brigadier General Narciso Domingo because he was not expecting that the people he should have trusted were the ones who made different erroneous reports that led to so many problems that we are now, the Senate is now investigating. So sana po, sir, let us keep on believing that more PNP are really mabubuti po kumpara po sa mga mangilan-ngilan. So dito po, maaari pong yung mga naakusahan ay matakasan po nila ang batas na pinairal po natin. But at the end of the day, when they are about to face yung great architect of the universe, definitely hindi po nila pwedeng kayang magsinungaling po sa ating Panginoong Diyos. Sana po ay this is a wake-up call to everybody that we need to be united in our fight against illegal drugs, against crime, because we all want to have a developed and robust country wherein everybody is enjoying life, because sabi nga namin dati, life is beautiful. Muli sir, maraming salamat po for the opportunity that you gave to the PNP and other law enforcement agencies so that we can rectify, we can correct all the misgivings and shortcomings of the PNP. And definitely sir, ang pangako po natin ay magba-bounce back po ang inyong PNP with the leadership under Brigadier Police General Acorda po. Alam ko po na from the very beginning na we started this investigation, sir, on board po ang ating Chief PNP. So tuloy-tuloy po ang purging po natin, and we should not allow people who have tainted credibility for them to still move up po. So dapat at our level ay we determine who are still suitable to continue serving the people, protecting and serving po the interest of the PNP organization as well as the interest of any administration. Muli, maraming salamat po at maganda.
General, kasama ka doon sa five-man team na nag-evaluate.
Yes, Mr.
Sino, sino yung mga dapat na mga general o mga colonels na involved sa droga?
Yes, sir.
Identified?
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Anong action taken?
There were four third-level officers po, sir. Dalawang brigadier general, dalawang full colonel po. That were recommended, sir, that administrative case will be filed.
Administrative?
Several administrative cases will be filed against them, sir. And there are other, 32.
Automatic na. Yun, di ba? Resignation yun. So, sibakin nyo na kagad o sasampahan nyo muna ng kaso?
Actually, diba, sir,
it's a form of resignation. So, i-accept nyo lang yung resignation. Tanggal na sila.
The advisory,
or you're going to give them another chance.
The advisory group, Mr. Chairman, sir, is only recommendatory in nature, sir. We evaluated, we assessed the suitability of the different third-level officers if they can still be promoted or assume higher positions, and the cases that will be filed against those people were forwarded to NAPOLCOM, sir, for NAPOLCOM to be the one to conduct the necessary investigation with the different charges that were identified with the different documents that were obtained by the advisory group, sir. And if ever, sir, na ma-found out na they are guilty, sir, actually, it will not even reach the Office of the President for him to approve or disapprove yung kanilang courteous resignation. Because if NAPOLCOM would find out na sila po ay guilty and ma-dismiss po sila, then there's nothing for the President to approve, Mr.
That is what you call due process, no po?
Yes, Mr.
So, sumusunod tayo doon sa due process.